Thank you. servants who shall position, raise them up, living in your thanks to thee. They shall make the great hope I ever seen in thy truth and thy destruction. They shall I wonder in thy darkness and thy righteousness and all that that is forgotten. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, my cry in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turn thy face away from me? A poor man am I, who grumbles from my youth, yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy fury is passed upon me, and thy fears have sorely troubled me. They came around me about like water all the day long, and compassed me about together. Thou hast removed it far from me, friend and neighbor, my acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cried by night. I cried in my hand before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down the ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within thee, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who filleth thy desire with good things. Thy youth shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not in the day will he anger, neither under eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord has made his mercy to prevail over them that feared him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his sons, so the Lord hath compassion upon them that feared him. For he knoweth wherever we are made, he hath remembered that feared us. As for man, his days are as the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over it, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it know its place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, and upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon them that keep his testament, and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all your angels, by your strength, and perform his word, hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all your hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all you whose works in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, and in thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness, and enter not judgment with thy servant, for thy sight shall command that he be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, yet humbled my life down to the earth, yet vacated the sap. He hath sat in darkness as those that belong to death. And my spirit within me is become despondent, within me my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated in all thy works, and pondered on the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest me like them and go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, where when I should walk, for to thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness, for thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou forgive me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction. And in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, for the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Dalton, Paul, and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return. Let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Glorious, and 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 glor
now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Save your disturbed apart of death, and with thee raising the bound. God, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, keep us, O Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
O blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Counted worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
Let us be attentive.
At that time, the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain which Jesus had directed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, to the close of the age." Amen.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In that we have beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. Thy cross to endure, O Christ, in that holy resurrection we praise thee, glorify. For thou art our God, and we know none other beside thee. We call upon thy name. O come, all ye faithful, let us adore Christ's holy resurrection, for lo, through the cross, the joy cometh to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, he hath destroyed death by death.
That first
shall be,
O God, according to thy great mercy, according to the multitude of thy compassion, blot out my transgression, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy word and forgiven in thy word and judge. Behold, thou hast conceived iniquity for instance to my mother's family. And behold, thou hast loved truth and hidden secret things with thy wisdom, thou hast made manifest unto me. Thou shalt bring me from this, and thou shalt be made free. Thou shalt wash me, and thou shalt be made white as snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness, and all the people will be sure of joy. Turn thy face to repentance, and tomorrow I will be with thee. Create me a clean heart, Father, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of that thy salvation, with that thou wilt prepare establish me. I will be found first with thy ways, and body shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, and thou wilt have God for salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness, O Lord. Thou shalt open my lips to my mouth to declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I'd give it. With bold burnt offering, thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice to God with a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humble, thou wilt not despise. Do good, O Lord, and thou approach me to Zion. And as the altar of Christ be built up, and shall be pleased to sacrifice to Christ, and with a flesh and bold burnt offering. Enter the offer of the upon thy hall of prayer. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, cause not the whole multitude of our transgressions, both now and ever. Sessions of the Theotokos, O thou who art merciful, cause out of the multitude of our transgressions.
Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions.
Jesus, having risen from the grave as he foretold, hath given
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Visit thy world with mercies and compassions. Exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians and send on down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our all immaculate, late Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable, by those powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable, glorious prophet, Foreign Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all alive holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril, and John, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentopolis, the Winter Workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious Greek martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Myrrh Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the God Bearer of Antioch, Olympias, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious Greek women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Fratini, Marina, Crescent, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of our righteous father, Heman the Great, of Egypt, Posius the Confessor, Bishop of Cordova, the martyr, and Utah, the newly revealed martyr, Marius of Rhodes, Caesareus, Bishop of Arles, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, and make our supplications unto thee, have mercy upon us.
Thank you.
Theotokos, and the Mother of the Light, let us honor and magnify in song.
Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Amen.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. O Master, lover of mankind, with thy light do we behold light, for thou art risen from the dead, granting salvation to the race of man, that the whole creation may glorify thee alone, who art without sin, have mercy upon us.
Praise him with the timbrel and dance, praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Verily the ointment bearing women, O Lord, did offer to thee their tears as a morning praise. For when they reached thy grave, bearing and singing sweet scent, hastening to seek thine incorruptible body, an angel ascending on the sun spake to them, saying, why seek ye the living among the dead? Verily he hath trodden down death, and is risen because he is God, granting to all great mercy.
Praise him upon the loud cymbals, praise him upon the high sounding cymbals, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. The brilliant angel on the life-giving tomb, to say to the ointment-bearing women, verily the Savior hath emptied the tomb, and hath led each captive, rising on the third day, for he alone is of his God.
Arise, O my God, lift up thy hand, and forget not the humble. On a Saturday, Mary Magdalene came singing in the grave, and when she found me not, she wailed, crying with sighs, and said, glorious be, O my Savior, how hast thou exalted staring angels, cried out to her, saying, woe betimes now, and she answered, saying, I cry because they have removed my Lord from the grave, and I know not where they have taken him. And but as she turned back in sobbing, she cried, saying, my Lord, glory to thee.
I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show all thy marvelous works. The Hebrews enclosed the tomb of life, but the thief did open paradise with his tongue, as he cried, saying, O thou who for my sake hath been crucified with thee, hast hung on the tree of the cross, and hast appeared to me, sitting on the throne with the Father. Thou art Christ our God, possessor of great mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son.
Of the Theotokos.
whole life unto you, Christ our God.
God and love us, mankind, and unto thee
stand upright. To the Lord.
Holy art thou, O God, and of thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever,
and unto ages of ages.
Have mercy.
let us attend.
Sing praises to our God, sing praises, clap your hands, all your nations.
Wisdom.
A reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, I would remind you in what terms I preach to you the gospel which you received, in which you stand, by which you are saved, if you hold it fast, unless you believed in vain. For I deliver to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ God died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. When he appeared to more than 500 brethren at one time, most of them are still alive, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God which is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we preach, and so you believed.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
And to thy
disciples, truly I say to you, it will be hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astonished, saying, who then can be saved? But Jesus looked at them and said to them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, our God is one. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ. Glory forever. Brothers and sisters, today marks the 12th Sunday after Pentecost, the 12th Sunday of the Gospel of Matthew. And today, in the reading, we hear the Lord's encounter with a rich man, or in St. Luke's Gospel, they call him the rich young ruler. Within these short 11 verses contains for us, the Christian believer, some of the most intense and most powerful language and dialogue the Lord has with anyone in the New Testament. An exchange we must consider honestly and soberly for our own lives. Teacher, what good deed must I do to inherit eternal life? Or if we put it in the common vernacular of the day, what do I do to be saved? The rich man was sincere. The rich man wanted to be saved like us. And just like us, that's why we're here this morning, right? Right?
Right.
Because if we're not, what are we doing here? Are we maintaining some type of moral obligation or some social commitment? If you would enter life, keep the commandments. The rich man saw salvation as a set of things that he could do. He could not see a distinction between his earthly riches and his possessions and what good works he could do to attribute them to salvation. What good work with my wealth can I perform that will grant me eternal life? And our Lord has a very curious expression. It's probably not curious to him. Say, but for us it's curious, when he says, if you would enter life, keep the commandments. In other words, if you would enter eternal life, if you would be made whole, you will keep the commandments. And then he goes on to tell what those commandments are, because he knew, being God, that the rich young ruler knew the commandments. And after he gives them commandments, the rich young ruler says to him, all these I have observed, what do I still lack? In St. Mark's Gospel, the same dialogue has Jesus saying, and Jesus looked upon him and loved him. And he loved him like he loved Lazarus, like he loved John the theologian, the Gospel. So Jesus didn't take the man's question lightly because he loved him. And our Lord reveals to us sometimes plainly and openly, as often are contained in the Gospels, sometimes delicately out for mercy for us and for our particular situation and personality, those things which we must do to be saved. And for this rich young man, he does the same. After listening the commandments, which he knows the young Lord knows, he says one thing to him. One thing you lack. And it was the one thing that he was unwilling to relinquish. Our Christian life is discipleship. Discipleship is discipline, a discipline to move from one degree of glory to the next. And Christ taught his disciples to take up their cross daily and follow him. Following Christ means to be willing to live, die, and even perhaps in this life suffer for each one of us, and for Him. He says, if you would be perfect, go and sell what you possess. In other words, get rid of those things, or in His case, the one thing that He was unwilling to get rid of. And that's us. All of us, if we are here and worried about our salvation, we'll come to God with that one thing, whatever it is. Anger, lust, covetousness. Because if we're about the business of salvation, those are the things that we will have and offer up to God for Him to heal us. If you would be perfect, go sell what you possess. And after the apostles had heard this discourse between the young man and Christ, you could almost feel they had to throw their hands up and say, as they say, Lord, who could be saved? And his retort to them was, with men, nothing is salvageable, but with God, all things are salvageable. So in essence, if we hear and understand our Lord's words and his admonishment to us, it's that when we think to ourselves, who can be saved? The answer is, everyone. Everyone can be saved. But we have to relinquish that one thing that keeps us from God. We teach our kids in our house that if you look around at the people they stand in church with, we believe and understand that literally these are the very same people that we'll see forever in God's kingdom. So with that sense of love, with that sense of care for each other, that's how we have to live our Christian life, with love. Because if we don't, St. Paul says we're just a loud sounding gong. And a loud sounding gong has no soul. So let this be our quest, brothers and sisters, to love one another. To put down those things that keep us from God and keep us as the rich and the poor. May we do this to his glory, of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, so God, by thy grace, wisdom.
That guarded always by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Thank you.
remembering his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Servants of God, especially for Peter and Alex, for the priest Andrew, for Alexander, Serena, Kevin, for Grierman, for Ricky, Lynn, and Amy, for Michelle, Lauren, Lori, Taylor, Stephanie, Mary, Christina, Claire, Autumn, Kelsey, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the newly departed Mary Sue, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, Let us ask of the Lord.
Have this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. That with one accord we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence and undivided.
All the benefits bestowed upon us, both Barnabas and Ananias. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and the thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, they are soaring aloft, toil of their wings, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
Joseph, whom do thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth. Mindful, O Lord, of those who travel by sea, by land, and by air, of the sick, the suffering, captives of their salvation. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit and do good works in thy holy churches, and who are never before. And upon us all, set forth thy mercies. And grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise thine all honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all. communion is served in the Eastern Orthodox Church can only be served to members of the Eastern Orthodox community. If you are not yet chrismated Orthodox, please refrain from this. We do offer the bread of fellowship, which is at the end of the service, which is not a sacrament, and that's free for all. Also, if you are Orthodox, but have not made, let's say, a recent confession, 6 months, 8 months, well, let's not feel entitled, as if this were somehow our right to just come up, ignore the rules of the church, and do as we please. It is not. This is the body and blood of Christ. So if you have not made a recent confession, you should refrain until you have.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Oh,
God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Grace and love for mankind, all
always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
By the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of our righteous father, Pimen, the great of Egypt, Hosius the confessor, bishop of Cordova, the martyr Anthusa of the New, the newly revealed martyr, Panurius of Rhodes, and Caesarius, bishop of Arles, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and love is mankind. Prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.